In today's video, I'm going to be going over how to rush in bedwars efficiently and showcasing certain strategies and how to use them correctly. But before I go over all of the strategies, I just want to say that you should try and tweak all of these methods before deciding on one, because there isn't one method over another, and all these methods are actually better depending on the situation. So, before leaving this video with one method, I highly suggest watching until the end to see all of these methods and finding the one you prefer. Now, with that out of the way, let me tell you the first strategy, which I call the bare hand strategy. So, when you get in the game, save up for 8 to 16 iron, and use it all for 32 to 64 pieces of wool. Don't even put a simple bed defense, not even that. Then, start bridging all the way to your opponent's base and get their bed. The purpose of this strategy is to use the Art of Surprise to your advantage. The reason why this works so well is because at this time, your opponent has either A, never moved from his gen or is still in their shop, B, built a wool bed defense which is very easy to break through. It can't be any other material like endstone since you will need to wait longer for either iron, and it cannot be wood since you have to wait longer for gold. The final option is C, and is that they are doing the exact same strategy you are doing. However, along with the strategy, there are a few cons. First of all, I would not recommend this if you don't know or aren't very fluent in speed bridging or any other faster method. Though, I would suggest getting fluent in speed bridging anyways. I also would not recommend it if you don't trust your PvP skills, which is completely alright, because that is the exact reason I don't use this method myself. The reason why is because one death in your bed is wide open and can be taken for grabs even before you respawn. It also doesn't work as well on maps that are spaced out, since those maps take more blocks than others. A good rule of thumb is to always bring 48 to 64 blocks on your rush, but depending on the map, you may need more or less blocks. The last con I can give is that other than your first rush, this rush isn't as effective. By then, you should already be doing some of the other methods which I will be talking about later in this video. If you are going to do this for your first rush, however, here are a few tips that can be useful. First off, manage your shop so you have your wool in an easy spot to access without wasting too much time. What I mean by this is that if you are still clicking the block section in the shop, that is still time wasted. Another tip is to either drop or stash your gold in your ender chest before leaving as quickly as possible. This gold can be later used to buy iron armor quicker or other useful items. So, to do this, either hold Control and Q while you're holding your gold out to leave it in your gen, or as you're running out, open your ender chest and hold shift and left click your gold and it'll store in your ender chest. My final tip I can give to you is to bridge up every 4 to 5 blocks when speed bridging. Do not flat bridge, please. By bridging up a little bit, there may still be a chance for you to respawn before they can get your bed. Plus, of course, you get the high ground. And by only going up every 4 to 5 blocks, it doesn't stop your sprint while walking on the bridge if you end up having to go for round 2. The next strategy is the TNT strategy. When you get in the game, place a basic wool bed defense or any iron bed defense and wait for 12 to 16 iron or more and 4 gold. Then, spend the iron for wool and the gold for TNT. From then, bridge up a lot because you will need the height advantage here. Then, you can drop the TNT and break the bed when the destruction is done. The reason for this is that TNT can break through many layers at once, which is very, very helpful if your opponent has something like, say, the hot dog bed defense, or the turtle, or whatever this guy is doing. Like, what even is this? And why this works so well is that your opponent can barely do anything about it. I mean, all they can do is spend 5 minutes getting a layer of glass, and who's actually gonna do that? This method is also incredibly useful for that one pesky player that hangs at their bed the entire time and somehow always kills you before breaking their bed. It always happens for some reason. So, this sounds amazing, right? But, however, like all strategies, there are cons. First off, 4 gold is super expensive. That is 1/3 of the price of iron armor, so say you mess up, especially on your first rush, and you can't break their bed, that is no bueno. Second, it also takes a lot of time. So say this is your first rush, if your opponent is doing the bare hand strategy I explained previously, they will more than likely have the advantage. Third is that this method works better on certain maps than others. This will be a lot better on slow gen maps compared to fast gen maps, since TNT will be the best option to break beds compared to tools on these maps. However, if you are going to use this, my first tip I can give to you is drop the TNT while you have the high ground. Instead of falling and placing the TNT when you are more vulnerable to combat, just place it on the side of the block. Since TNT has gravity when lit, it'll just fall on the bed defense while you're at the top. Second, position yourself so that you place the TNT on the corner of the bed instead of the top of the bed. By actually doing it on the top, there's a bigger chance that it won't expose the bed. So, on the other hand, do it on the corner because you have the best chance of breaking the bed since it explodes the most amount of blocks in its area. The third tip is that if your opponent has glass on their bed defense, jump down, break the glass, and then place the TNT. Glass is uncommon in singles and doubles, so you should not have to worry about it really, unless you're doing it in threes and fours. So since you are likely to die when you drop down, bring a friend with you in threes and fours to jump when the explosion happens, while you can just take the sacrifice. 07, my friend. It was for the right cause. My final tip for you is to time when you drop down, which is super, super important to know. If you time it so that you can break the bed right when the TNT explodes, you have the least likely chance of getting immediately hit off into the void. So, to do this, jump when the TNT flashes white for the fourth time. The TNT will blast at the fifth, so if you time it correctly, it'll force your opponent to stay away from the TNT, meaning a guaranteed bed. The third strategy is the complete opposite of using TNT, which is the tool strategy. Similarly to the first strategy, get around 32 to 36 iron, and buy with 12 to 16 of the iron wool and the 20 iron either a pickaxe and axe or shears. You can also wait another 20 iron to complete the set if you want, but I would suggest doing this later in the game. Before buying your tools, check what block it is, because if it's wood or endstone, get a pick and axe, but if it's wool, then just get shears. From there, you can bridge to your opponent and get their bed. For bed defense, that will completely depend on you, but some suggestions would be to use one layer of wool, hot dog, or turtle. The reason this is so good is because the tools are there forever, meaning you can constantly use them over and over again. Now for the cons, it is on the pricey side and is not very useful when doing your first rush. It also does not work well at all on maps like Airshow that have a slow gen map. This method is quite self-explanatory, but I can give some tips to help you out. My first tip is if they are at their base, have the high ground before jumping down. The reason for doing this is you can check for minor fatigue traps, which you can find using clients like Lunar Client. The other tip I have is to block in if necessary. Blocking in is quite the skill to learn, and I'm personally really, really bad at it. But if you want to practice, there are servers like Bedwars Practice Club for you to learn and master it. This is especially important if you're going to do 3s and 4s, because you will need to burrow away from several people from time to time. So there are the three main methods, but your method will really depend on your playstyle and your personal skills. If you want to use my hybrid strategy, I personally use the all-in strategy, but I get a strange wool hot dog hybrid bed defense. I usually get 16 to 20 iron, which gets me 64 to 80 wool. I use 16 of the wool for the bed defense and the rest for bridging, and I can usually get to the next base before they rush me, unless, well, I have this sweaty gamer. After my first rush, I just get tools and don't really use TNT much. But the options are limitless, and don't feel limited to the options I give you. Continue out trying new things until you're comfortable with your own strategy. And if you do have a unique strategy you want to share, consider commenting it down below. Now, thank you for watching, and without further ado, peace.